everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about qualitative research methods, sampling techniques, like what kind of sampling techniques do we use that are very specific to qualitative research methods. Now, let me clarify this before we move into the video, that all the sampling techniques that we use for quantitative methods equally apply here on qualitative research method, like, you know, the random sampling and you could say non-random sampling and all other techniques within these two methods. But there are certain special techniques that we have to follow while we're going for qualitative research methods. So let's begin the video. So most commonly we use non-random sampling, purposive sampling method. But yes, we can go for a random sampling method, but the most common method that's used here is purposive sampling. What does it mean by having purposive sampling? It means that we select the respondents that meet a particular criteria. For example, you want to have an insight into that why people watch the YouTube videos, then you would want to have the respondents who watch the videos. So you would not select people randomly from a population, but you would specifically select the people who are in habit of watching videos on YouTube. Moving on, we have another rule that's called extreme case selection. What does it mean? You select the respondents who have different kind of characteristics. For example, if I'm analyzing the data coming from YouTube video watchers, I'll select some who are male and then some who are female, some who are really young and some who are really old and some who are middle-aged. So what does that mean? That we want to have a variety of participants, variety of respondents within our data set. We also have, like, you know, crisscross of cases, like, you know, if I have male and female and age as variables, I would also try to make sure that I have some young females, some young males, and then I have some older males and some younger males as well. So, you know, I have a combination of different characteristics, extreme characteristics within my sample that I have selected. For this, we have a rule that's called feather and stone variation rule. It means, like, you know, some of your respondents would be very light on the characteristic and some of them would be really heavy on that particular kind of, you could say, characteristics. You know, the extremes of a quantum. Then we have another rule that's called data saturation. Like, you know, how much or what would be the size of sample that you would be selecting? So one of the rule, or you could say a rule of thumb that is followed in the qualitative data analysis or qualitative research method, is that you keep on selecting until the data saturation occurs. And what does it mean by data saturation? That you don't receive any new information from a respondent that you are interviewing or you're observing. So from that point onward, you collect the data from 3 to 4 more cases. And if the data keeps saturating, you would stop your data collection process. So these are the few rules, you could say, that we follow in qualitative research method. Hope you have liked this video. Please subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any other video from this channel. Hope to see you soon again. Bye.